What's up, TV Land? Good evening.
Good evening. There's our boy.
Here he is, the boss.
The boss.
Hello. That was so unprofessional.
Well, you may have a story behind it, so please stay tuned.
Yeah, we have a story. We're going to explain why I wasn't on the set to begin with. But how's everybody doing today?
Good evening.
Awesome. I love being here, so it's a good time.
Good.
Always. I've been off for a week, so I'm happy.
I've been off from
the day job for a week, so I am in such WUSA status that I don't know. I don't even know how I'm going to go back.
All right. Well, vacation is good, especially right before the new year, too.
Oh, my gosh, yeah. Should just have off all week. I feel like from Christmas to New Year's, like, everybody should just be off.
Yes.
Think about how much more productive people would be when the year started, probably all the way through. Absolutely.
I agree 100%.
That's what I say. You get to digest the whole family holidays thing.
All right, so we didn't even introduce anything to show anything. Welcome, everybody, you watching and listening to Strong Island Live. It is Wednesday night. It is 10 o'clock. As usual, we broadcast from 10 to 11. I am L.A. the Boss, and I have my ladies with me. What's up, girls? Introduce yourselves.
Hey, boss. It's Miss Chrissy here. Good to see you guys again. It's Jamie Grace. Good evening.
See, I never know how you're going to... Sometimes you're so quiet, and sometimes you're loud. I never know how you're going to introduce yourself.
You know,
it's a Gemini doll.
Yeah, we kind of feed off each other. Like, if I feel like maybe she's going to be quiet, then maybe I'm a little quiet. I don't want to over...
Yes.
I don't want to...
I noticed that.
I don't want to, like, overpower with my loud...
You guys kind of... you kind of...
We have a good vibe.
You equalize each other out.
That's why we're friends.
That's why it's good to have a Gemini on either side.
Except when the wine gets halfway and then I can't get a word in and you guys are just...
Halfway through, then we're like, bop, 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 bop.
Well, it also depends on the guest, too.
The guest. Which we have a lovely guest here tonight. We're very excited about.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, we do. Who do we have tonight? She's not on the screen, but who do we have? Just let everybody know.
Well, we have my good friend Tara Rickert. She's a professional competitive bodybuilder, fitness model, and personal trainer, amongst many other things that she does, and she's just an awesome person, as usually
she's
the people on here are.
Multifaceted.
Mm-hmm. And beautiful inside and out.
Aww, that's
and really she'll
sweet.
Kick your ass. She's got a lot of muscles.
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 I'd be afraid to go out with her because I know I have a mouth and I'd feel like she'd have to back me up with her muscles.
Exactly. That could be added to her list of achievements. Well, she could be a bodyguard.
That's true.
I do need one sometimes.
Yes, I could.
I mean,
see
I can
you.
Hold my own, but
yes, and you know,
I need one because my muscles do not back up my mouth. So
yeah, no, Jamie, well,
no,
Jamie, you can call me if you need me.
I would fight till the death, but I would die very quickly.
She going down with a fight.
All right, so we're gonna bring her on in a couple minutes, but first, I wanted to say that I just heard the news that Debbie Reynolds passed away, and I was
so
like
sad.
I was like, Debbie Reynolds, I'm like, I know the name, and I couldn't think of it. And you guys, that's Carrie Fisher's mom. Mm-hmm.
Leia's mom.
That's a day after her daughter dies. I mean, oh my God, that's so
terrible.
Can you
imagine the heartbreak though that she went through? I mean, like, you don't happen. Obviously her heart like had probably hurt.
You never so much. A parent never wants to bury their children. That's definitely, you know, not a good thing.
No.
But that's just crazy, man. A day later she just must have been devastated. It reminds me of the you know those couples that are married, they're just so in love.
Yeah, it happens a lot.
You know, and they're inseparable for their whole lives. And then one of them passes and literally hours or within days, the other one passes too. It's just like crazy. They must have just had an amazing connection.
My great-grandfather went a month to the day after his wife.
Oh, wow.
It happens too, like simultaneously.
Natural causes. It was nothing.
That's
you know,
what I'm saying.
It wasn't
just
a heart attack.
Natural,
it was
not,
just
yeah.
he...
Incredible.
Went to sleep
it's like
month
almost
to the
like
day
a,
after
like a broken heart, you know, dying of
but
a broken
they're
heart.
But actually, I just saw a study not too long ago that they actually diagnosed it that there is something that when you go through such intense grief, that it can actually have an effect on the fibrillation within your heart. So
I hear you.
You know, they say it's dying of a broken heart, but it literally has an effect of the way, you know, your body.
That happened to that girl. Remember when those girls were. I mean, like, listen, we don't like to talk about this stuff usually, but it's crazy because remember that happened to the girls that were held captive by that guy for many, many years, and even one of them had a daughter. And by the time they were found and they were taken out of custody of the guy, and she had found out her mom had passed away years before because mm-hmm. she died of a broken heart. Mm-hmm. Like, could you imagine? You think your daughter's gone forever, and then... Yeah. You know,
and then you die, and then she comes back, and it's like, I mean, where's my mother? And she's like, oh, she died. She thought you died. And
it's just, it's heartbreaking. Terrible. It's sad.
That's why don't die unless you're sure the other person is dead.
Yeah, that's a good,
you know? We learned that from Shakespeare. It's a good rule.
Make certain, please.
Shakespeare instilled that in us.
All right, so I want to apologize. We started the show, and there was an empty chair here. Okay,
yeah, what's going on?
We don't have an engineer here tonight. Half Chub is gone. Half Chub is not coming back.
He's whipped. That's why and I saw it happen.
Let me just tell you, this is my theory, okay? And I'm no rocket scientist, okay? But this is my theory, and I have it rounded down to three steps. Mm-hmm. Okay? Half Chub gets a girlfriend.
Yep.
Jamie Grace posts a half naked picture on Facebook. Half Chub likes the post, comments, wow. Half Chub disappears.
It's all my fault.
No, but you know what? That's what's ridiculous to me, because when you're in this kind of like profession or business, or you know what I'm saying, even in just life in general.
But he really wasn't in the business. he was behind the scenes. No, he wasn't even in front of the scenes.
But what I mean is being around beautiful people, such as Jamie over there, who, let's tell it like it is, fills out a bathing suit and a bikini pretty freaking good. You know, for nothing, but then don't have social media.
Well, first of all, when you have a girlfriend, seriously, when you have a girlfriend, you should not be liking pictures.
I don't think I'm friends with the girlfriend on Facebook.
No, but still, you're just asking for trouble. Yeah. Okay, you're asking for trouble. What was it? A bikini picture or something like that?
Yeah, it was a shoot that I had done a year ago. So I liked the picture and I just changed.
That's fine. You can post whatever you want. But my advice to guys, if you're in a relationship, don't start liking pictures of girls in bikinis or, you know. You just got to be careful. It's a fine line. And especially,
he just came into a relationship.
He didn't just like it. He posts wow in capitals. W-O-W in capitals. And like I said, I'm no rocket scientist.
It was probably because he was so shocked that picture was actually me because of him seeing me in person all the time.
It was probably because it's cuffing season and he just needed to cuff somebody for the season and forgot that he doesn't like girls.
Ooh.
Ooh, half chub.
But no, I just feel like, you know.
Shots fired.
I have to say, though, right? I'm kind of glad my significant doesn't have social media and doesn't care, like, to know what I do, because I can kind of say and do what I want, which isn't really anything bad. I don't talk to anybody I shouldn't. I like things that I like, and even if it's a guy and I see a hot guy on Instagram, maybe, that I'm like, ooh, hello. like, it's not like I'm like, ooh, I'm going to seek him out and try to do the dirty with him. Mm. Nice picture. You look good.
If your partner is on insecure social media and they are active.
It's a new relationship, though. She shouldn't be like that insecure. I mean, like, maybe she is. If you shouldn't be with somebody, though, if I don't know. I see things differently, I guess. Well, I just don't agree with.
Listen, we can't be certain. I'm just saying. It's just a little coincidental.
Right? It literally happened right after.
Well, how do you know? What do you listen? We don't know the whole story, cuz Half Chub could have went home that night and couldn't even get a half chub.
Oh, man.
Unless looking at pictures of Jamie.
And then, oh, my gosh.
He only got a quarter chub.
Or maybe he had one.
So
and
his
she
girl's like, she must have been like, half chub? You can't even get a half chub. You come to me with a quarter chub? That's not cool. So we don't know what happened.
Yo, we have to like copyright that quarter chub.
You got me blushing over here.
I got you blushing.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, the Irish girl on the right.
Oh, my God.
I just think it's funny because, like, I don't know. I wouldn't. It's just kind of like, you're going to be mad at him for liking a picture. So
well, we don't know. We're allegedly.
It's
we don't
new.
Know. We don't well, know. All right. Allegedly. But for everybody who's just tuning in right now, we're talking about how we don't have an audio or video engineer tonight, so I'm running the show myself. So you may see me get up a couple times during the show. I apologize. But we were just saying, you know, we have you know, a worker here, and he was doing so well. He was happy at his job. He actually told me he loved his job here.
Gee, I wonder what happened.
And then all of a sudden, Jamie posts a picture half naked in a bikini. He likes the post and hits wow, and apparently he disappears from that moment on. We don't know what happened to him. So
you'll know when we see him again is when they break up. He'll be like, hey, can I get that job back?
We're assuming that his new girlfriend.
Maybe I should unfriend him and then see if he comes back.
I don't know, but we wish him all the best. But anyway,
yeah, good luck,
so F-Chub. That's the reason. So I'm actually, with that being said, I am going to get up now. I'm going to go over to the booth, and I am going to bring in our guest. So while I do that, why don't you just take your time and introduce your friend? And I'm very excited. We have a great show tonight.
Well,
and I'm looking forward to it.
I'm going to hold down the fort for you there, boss. So met this lovely woman a few years ago on another show I was doing and instantly connected. She's just such a good heart, good person, very smart. She's driven. She knows a lot about a lot of stuff, and not just in her profession, but in life in general. And, I mean, she's badass. She's just a badass chick. I mean, this is Tara, Tara Rickard over here. Say hello, Tara.
Hello, Tara.
Hello, Tara.
That's a lot to live up to right there. That was a hell of an introduction.
Well, I mean, that's what we do.
Thank you. Thank you.
All about You're the welcome. Love.
Yes. Yeah, I've known Chrissy a long time now.
Yeah. And
we,
see,
we
she calls
go a few years back.
She calls me by my name. I'm not used to that,
Chrissy.
But how she met me, as Chrissy.
Chrissy.
So. But tell us, you know, I mean, I already did the introduction, so, you know, tell us a little bit about
me,
about what you do, and, you know, what you're...
And then we'll interrogate you
first. Great.
FBI.
I would say for the most part, I'm a personal trainer. That's my day in, day out. I run a small business out in Texas, as you know. I grew up here on Long Island. I've been doing fitness and fitness-oriented things for ever. As you can see, I posted that picture on Facebook today from like 22 years ago. So I've been around the block here with this for a little while. And I'm just venturing into some other things, a lot more online training, trying to reach out more to the masses, get people involved in some other avenues and some other things that I'm working on, which we'll touch on a little bit later. But I do a lot of fitness modeling. I don't know, you know, it's just been... It's primarily personal training. I got a sponsorship, you know, with a supplement company, so I do a lot of work with them, with Mutant. They're a big, big, big part of my life now. That was a huge blessing for me, huge blessing this past year. I would consider myself pretty lucky, you know, overall. It's a tough industry, but I think if you do it the right way, there's longevity in it.
Okay, so tell us, go back to the beginning. How did you get started? What did you get into first? Did you just start getting into working out?
I was a heavy kid in high school, actually, through my senior year. And then in college, when the 80s fitness craze really hit, like the step aerobics and all that kind of stuff.
Was that the only way that I used?
Yes. Yes,
oh my
I was there.
I love
I'm not kidding. I was just going through, not
so
to interrupt, but this is good. I was just going through, I got this silly app where you can like sell old VHSs and DVDs and this, that, and the other thing. So I literally started tearing out the boxes of whatever I could find. I found a Richard Simmons Sweat Into the Oldies. That is incredible. I found Carmen Electra Hip Hop.
Oh, that's a good one.
Oh.
That is great. I found a...
that's an old one, too.
What is it? I think pole dancing and strip aerobics. I think that
that's
one was Carmen
did,
Electra, too.
That's the one you just dig out and did.
Absolutely.
I know it.
I had Buns of Steel.
And, no. And
my mom had the Buns of Steel.
And a Jane Fonda.
Ugh. I won't comment
no, but
on Jane,
but it was just hilarious to see like her on the cover with the leg warmers and
the whole
thing.
Suzanne
Summers. And the best part
Summers.
About that,
what she was the thing Thighmaster.
The Thighmaster, yes. There you go.
Yes, she was the original thigh gap bitch.
She was.
She was.
She made that up.
We can blame her for the thigh gap.
Yes. Yeah, I was in a lot of, I wasn't in any of those videos, by the way, none of that stuff. Just for the record.
Oh my God, my friend Lisa Tybo.
What is the definition of a thigh gap? Can you get into that?
Like, there's a gap between your two thighs.
It's unnatural. It's just the way some people are built and some people aren't. But this became this thing.
I could get that if I didn't eat like Taco Bell every day.
Not everybody can, though, because it was only
the twiggiest of people. You know, you
can. The only time I ever had a thigh gap was when I was 103 pounds. And that was unnatural for me. Somebody just commented on one of those pictures and was like, you need a big sandwich.
Yeah.
But it's not necessarily a natural thing. It's just when your thighs don't touch in the middle.
I saw that picture you posted of the 80s.
When they touch, there's a little opening there.
It was the Everlast.
Gotcha.
The really tight ones that like show kind of your vajay, but like kind of cover just the lip part.
But they used to put the spandex underneath. Like underneath the leotard, like, you know.
That was to guard against the camel toe.
I don't know what that was to guard against. Either way, it looks stupid. I don't know what people
that was because he needed two layers.
And then the white high top socks.
It was bad all
with
around
sneakers.
Bad. We should just skip over the whole 80s
all
era.
All right, so get back to anyway. So when you got started, what did you get
right
into first?
I was in college, and I met a coach for a football team, and he had this really cool gym set up in his basement. And I had just started to kind of get into all this stuff and was working in a gym. And he said, you know, if you want to learn to be, you know, a personal trainer and really kind of do this on the side, you can open your own business, you can use my gym. So he kind of really coached me along the way as far as getting clients, you know, and how this stuff. And I was so young, you know.
It's amazing to have a mentor
so
like
young.
That at
he
that
was amazing.
Age, yeah.
He was great. And he really kind of got me started in that stuff. And it really just kind of took off from there. Once he kind of moved away, I decided to open up my first studio. I think I was 22.
Wow,
I had
22.
My first studio. Yeah. And that was here on Long Island. That was in Bohemia. I started that. And then I fell off, you know, a little while, you know, through the years. You know, you go through your 20s and 30s. And I was still in the gym and doing that stuff, but not as seriously. And then a couple of years back, like 2008 and 9, when I was in Houston, I decided, you know, I want to compete. And I wanted to take that to the next level. And I actually started in, like, figure. I was so tiny. And after I did the figure show, I looked at the girls that were doing the bodybuilding, and I just fell in love with that sport. I did not want to go back from that. I just wanted to be big. I wanted to go lift heavy things. I wanted to be, you know, at the top of that food chain.
I would have picked things up and put them
down. Literally. And
that was
it from that day forward. And, you know, I was so headset in just going that way that it was, I would do anything to win. Mm-hmm. And this is something we kind of talked about earlier. You know, I took any supplement people recommended. You know, I was sticking myself with all kinds of crazy things. It was like being Frankenstein, hence the voice now. You know, I used to be a singer like Chrissy. I'm kidding. I was never a singer. But, you know, I get a lot of that stuff. The voice change was, of course, a side effect that, you know, will never go away from some of those choices then. And now, being through the industry, there's so many other things that women can do or can do in a different way that, you know, wouldn't give them that same result.
So what kind of commitment did that take to, because you're not just building your body, you're competing.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know,
yeah, competition. And nowadays, and it's nothing against the sport, nowadays it's kind of, I say, easier for people because there's so many different divisions. When I first went to get on the stage as a bodybuilder, my coach looked at me and he was like, absolutely not. He was like, no, you're not ready. You know, I'm not going to do this to you. No, come back and see me in a year. You know,
but at least you had somebody that wasn't just a yes man saying,
yeah, you know,
yeah,
now
keep
everybody
putting money
gets
in my
on a
pocket,
stage.
Get on stage. And
everybody
then,
goes,
you know,
if you're not a bodybuilder, they'll put you in this class. If you're not that class, they'll put you in this class. There's a
I
class
was approached
for everybody.
About figure modeling. And I was like, I said, honestly, I said, what you see is what you get, because I'm not going to train for this. Mm-hmm. I'm not committed to that. If you,
those are, it's tough. The,
you know,
the competition side of it is tough. I think that,
and I didn't do it because
isn't.
I knew that I wasn't going to commit to it, and that was the thing. I said, literally, I was like, if you think that you want to put me on your team because you like what you see right now, and that was my but that was the thing. That was my way of telling him, like,
no.
Bye.
Yeah.
You know, like don't push
but
this.
But pretty much
you
everybody
know,
that,
kind of
that you competed against were taking the same supplements you were.
Oh,
it's
yeah,
like
yeah.
It wasn't that
yes.
easy. It wasn't
oh,
like
yeah.
somebody could just be like, oh, I'm not gonna do anything, but I'm just gonna work
and there's
out.
Now,
here.
I mean, it's a lot easier now. There's a lot of natural organizations that people can compete in. You know, so they really have a lot of choices and different things they can do, which is fantastic for the sport. And I'm whatever people want to do, it's personal choice.
Yeah.
I made my choice when I was doing it. I would never tell someone, you know, no, don't. But I would at least try and give them better advice on how to do things, you know, where to get things that aren't, you know, detrimental to their health in the long run.
That there are people like you that are still involved in the industry and really, I mean, not even just like, you know, for doing what you're doing, but involved with people that are younger, you know, and actually like making a difference there.
You try to. I mean, I don't know if somebody would have told me then, you know, hey, don't do this, this, and this. You know, in 10 years, you're going to pay the price. You know, when you want to win and you have that competitive, you know, you're going all out and you're not going up there to take second and third place. You know, nobody has that in their mind, or at least they shouldn't, to be like, oh, I just wanted to do it. The idea is to go up there and do something and be competitive with it. So, you know, I would never tell anyone to do it or not to do it. You know, if you're going to do everything to win, you're going to do it. And I don't know if I would have listened to someone, you know, older and wiser than me then. You know, I don't know. I can just hope that maybe someone will listen
but
to
regardless,
it
now. You would, know, you but try. Right now, sitting in that chair, you'd be like, well, so-and-so did tell me.
And there's probably...
But, you know what I mean? Yeah, though, it's like, at least that voice could have been there.
Yeah.
So think of yourself in that way.
You could disregard that.
Yeah, and then, but it is a choice to disregard it.
Absolutely.
At least the voice is there.
Absolutely.
And you know, train. And you're being that.
You train other, I mean, because you're a trainer, so you train other people that are trying to get into these competitions as well. Do a lot of them not take
I have mostly, I mean, it's funny because competitive-wise, most of my competitors that I train are all natural. Which is such a, which is really such as like a switch for
really?
Me.
Really? No,
but it's
like
actually
good,
kind of refreshing. You know, they work really hard. They work really hard. I think some people have a tendency to think that just because you're taking some gear or you're on some steroids, that that is what does the work, and it doesn't.
No.
It might help you a little bit along the way,
like
but
technology.
It does not. It does not do the work for you.
Making
it is not
it a
the easy
easier.
Solution. But natural athletes, if you look at them, they work so much harder because they have to.
And
you
that's know, why I wouldn't
they
compete.
Diet, their,
that is
their
exactly why I wouldn't compete.
Is insane. I mean, they are do or die all the time. You know, they don't stray from their diets. They don't, you know, stray from their training in the world. I mean, they really give it their all. I have some amazing online clients that do this stuff with me that just, they blow me away. I mean, they keep me motivated. I'm like, holy shit, this stuff does work. No, you know, when you look at them and you see how hard they work, it's truly amazing.
You got
to
be careful, too, because you can hurt yourself.
Yes.
If
you're
not training
right
or if you're taking the wrong things.
Yeah.
And if you're not fueling your body while you're working that hard.
It's a fine balance. And I mean, everybody has the tendency to go too far, overtrain or anything and exhaust themselves. So it's been really important for me that any of my clients that sign up, I mean, they... I had one guy actually kind of joke. He was like, you really want me to fill all this paperwork out? But it's a full medical.
Yeah.
I need, you know, because I need to know. I might, if you're on medication and I feed you something, it could be my fault that something happens.
Liability.
This is
huge. This is your brand. This is your business.
Yes. And I would never want someone to turn around and be like, well, you know, so-and-so, you know, she really screwed me up. You know, I would try not to have that happen is the goal.
Yeah. Like, you know, I have a mitral valve prolapse. I have a heart. You know, an aggravated heart murmur with a leaky valve.
Okay,
and
so
and I dated a personal trainer. So he used to be like, cardio, babe, cardio. And I'm like, yes, but you don't understand. I have to build my heart up to that because watch, after 10 minutes, my heart rate is going to be 180.
Yeah.
And you're going to freak out. You know, like,
and it happens. I've seen people do it in the gym, you know.
There's a lot of people that don't know what they're doing.
And it happens everywhere. I mean, it's like anything.
Yeah.
That would be
but
like me coming up here and being like, I know how to do radio.
I don't know how to do radio. What the hell am I doing here?
Yeah. You're faking it really well.
Those things are so important.
I do.
It
know?
Is. So, you know, I make it a really big point to make sure that I know their medical history, injuries, prior injuries. I mean, all of that stuff comes into play when you're making a program for someone.
How long did it... My question is, how long did it take you, like, from when you decided you wanted to start doing it to being in your first competition? Like, how much work and did you put in to actually get to that point where you were, like, ready to go?
I would say knocked out the first one. And like I said, that was figure at the time. So I really
love how
just
you
had
say
to
knocked
kinda,
out.
Like, die. It's y'all and knocked out. And she likes two words.
Y'all. Love it.
It took me 15, 16 weeks to prepare for it. And I wouldn't say I was like in great shape. I was okay. You know, I was fit, but I wasn't, you know, what I would consider fit now. But I did that one in the 16 week prep. And I did all right. I placed sixth, you know, and it was the first show that I had ever done. So it was fun. And then after that, it took me 2.5, almost 3 years solid of just hardcore training and picking heavy things up and tossing that stuff around to go into bodybuilding.
What was like the highest award?
But that was completely different.
I won state, Texas State.
Yeah, I was going to tell us about some of the things that the competitions that you did win.
The 2008 was figure. That was the first show. And like I said, I placed sixth that show. And a couple years later, I went straight into bodybuilding. The first show, I didn't do so great. You know, it's maybe third and fourth. But there weren't a lot of girls in the group. There were maybe 5 bodybuilders at the time. In 2011 or 12, it was somewhere around there, I finally got that first place win. It was Texas State.
Wow. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Yeah,
oh, the whole, and that's a big state.
It was a good show.
Yeah, that is
the
a
Texas
big
State show is even,
arguably
Texas
the
State
biggest.
Show is still a huge, huge, huge show. It's still probably one of the biggest in Texas.
Yeah.
It's a great show. But that was that moment that, you know, I had to sit back from it and be like, did that really happen?
All the work paid off.
It was amazing. It really was.
Yeah, that's
and the
great.
Team I was working with, some of the other women that were there, you know, everybody was backstage and just like, oh my God, you know, it was a great moment. It was
fantastic.
Yeah,
is are people like, when you go to these competitions, because everybody obviously is like very goal oriented for that first place and like, you know, competitive and especially since, you know, people are taking certain supplements that might make them a little angry. Do you get along? Like, does everybody kind of?
I was going to ask that. Like, yeah.
Right? Is it like being in a club bathroom when you're in the back preparing? Like, oh my God, you look so cute. And then we leave room like,
oh my God, look at the tone of her glaze. Oh my God.
Your tan is so off.
Your bronze is so bad. I should give you a number of somebody.
There is a lot of camaraderie to the sport, but there is also, of course, like anything else, your share of people that you can stand. You know, there's people that will help you along the way. And I think, and it's nothing against women per se, but women are very closed mouth. They don't want to say what they're doing, how they train, you know. And me, I'm like an open book. I'll be like, oh yeah, I took this, and this for this show. You know, did it work? How did you feel? You know, was it different? And there's really not a lot of that. Women really don't talk about it at all.
Oh, because they don't want anybody to bite their style, so they don't.
I'm just gonna put this out there, because just my experience is, guys support each other more than women.
Oh, so much more.
I completely agree with you.
No, that
but
is true.
It's just I see it in a lot of things, a lot of businesses, even here. Girls being on shows together. These two, you got to omit them because they're good friends. But there's a lot of competition, and girls really, they really don't support each other the way that guys do.
No.
And it's unfortunate.
It is. It's really sad.
Because in reality, we are a minority. I mean, you know, like we are in one of those groups that does not have, you know, the epitome of rights that, you know, others do. So, you know, it's really important for us to support each other.
I mean, with anything, you're going to find, you know, people that are genuinely happy for your success or for your achievements. Finding those people are few and far in between. You know, those are the people that really make the grade. You know, it's the ones that when you finally get something good happen, and, you know, the ones that are all kind of catty about it, or, you know, that'll down talk it or downplay it, those are the ones that are not really your friends, you know, in the long run. Someone's genuinely happy for your success, they're your friends.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
There's a lot. I mean,
and that's the way to test it. You
there's
know
all
mean?
That
honestly.
On social media too. Like, you see, like you might be friends with like however many people,
God.
Like thousands of people on it. But when those people are like constantly not liking or supporting what you're doing, it's like, well, why are you watching me? Like, or you just have me is like
or,
to make yourself
or they
look
just
popular.
Come on and make the other odd comments. You know,
like,
there's a lot of hate.
There is.
There's a lot of anger and hate. Social media has brought a lot of angry things to light.
Now, talk about that. I know that me and you obviously on the side have talked about this.
Yeah.
And, you know, one thing that you have come to terms, a lot of people do obviously in certain situations, but you especially with what you do have dealt with a lot of like backlash and people putting you down for what you're doing or what you sound like or what you look like. And, you know, they don't even give you a chance as who you are to know you as a person, which I do.
Oh, hold that thought. We got
a call. We like phone calls. Hold on.
Got a fan.
StrongIsland.com. Who's on the line? Where are you calling from?
Hi, my name is Julia. I'm calling from Queens. I am dying to talk to Tara Rickert.
What's up, Julia?
Hi, Julia.
She's there. Ask her.
Hi.
Oh, my God. How are you?
I am awesome. I am so excited that you're even... I saw the Facebook post. I couldn't even believe that you were going to be on Long Island. I swear, I'm so motivated that you're even here. I'm watching, I'm streaming you live. I'm like literally so motivated. I will run from Queens right now.
Don't run from
Queens. The train station is right next to us.
Don't run from Queens.
I will run there right now if I get your autograph. I'm so excited that you're even in New York.
Julia, tell us, how are you aware of
how do you know? How did you
And what do you admire about her?
I have followed her for like, oh my God, I'm like literally watching, like as I'm talking to you guys, freaking me out. I literally have followed her forever since like Texas State days and everything.
Oh, wow.
Just knowing that she was from New York, I'm a mother of two. So I literally like battled with baby weight and just, you know, you don't eat right. You pick on whatever you're making for your kids and went on her website.
Busy.
She totally made me the most awesome diet plan like ever. Then I was like, oh, well, this is great. And then I was like, oh my gosh, she does training plans. Whatever.
Yeah.
I have literally lost like 30 pounds.
Yay! Good
job. Yay! Congratulations!
And literally, like, I don't feel like a big fat mom. You know, like,
well, you know, and it's tough with kids. It's hard with kids.
It's so hard. And she totally geared something around where I wasn't like, oh, I have to get to the gym. It was so easy. It was just so, like, she worked with me so much. You know, my schedule and what I was doing, what I eat. I don't like broccoli. Okay, she totally would. I was like, oh, my God. Like,
that's my biggest issue.
Well, and that's, literally, I think a lot of trainers like, do
and
online
still
plans.
Still losing, because I'm not going to lie. I packed it on and ate, you know, oh, I'm eating for two when I was pregnant. Like,
she ate for
not
going
to lie. No. Totally feel the best I've ever felt in my life, and it's all thanks to her.
Thank you.
I'm like the biggest fan. I'm so mad that I literally would have been like banging on the door like, I was like, give me an autograph if I knew you were here.
Julie, when we're done, let me know. And you can always, contact me on any of my social medias or through the website. We'll send some gifts out to you.
I have so much to thank you for. That's awesome. Not even funny.
You're very, very welcome. Congratulations on your weight loss. It's amazing.
Thank you for everything. You're the best.
Thank you so much.
Right. We'll send us a message, and I'll send some stuff out to you.
Yeah, thank you. You've been like the cutest caller ever. Thank you so much. We love you. Thank you.
Love you guys. You guys have the greatest show. Thank you guys.
Thank you. Much love, Mama.
Spread the word.
Have a good night, everybody.
Bye. She's going to run from Queens.
She's so cute.
That really was the cutest call I think we've ever gotten.
And those are like the great fans that you have that
I have,
keep you motivated.
Clearly you're changing
doing
lives.
So
I
keep
have
doing
met
what
so many
doing.
Good people. You know, there's that air of negativity to things.
Going to touch
like somebody commented on one of my pictures today that, you know, you look better than before. I don't know, however they put it. They're English.
And you should have been like, yeah, but I couldn't pick things up and put them down.
Yeah, but you know what's nice is that. Like,
That wasn't solicited.
That wasn't your friend or somebody you know personally. That was somebody who truly you have inspired, and they've been following you for a long time.
Their life has changed.
It has definitely blown my mind. I think this past year has really... I get some amazing messages. I get amazing messages from people. Veterans, I do a lot. Anything I can do for veterans, disabled veterans, there's a lot of stuff going on. And I always offer something, you know, for any services. I figure I at least owe that back. You know, they give me the freedom to be here and do what I do every single day and bitch about every little thing in my life that I whine and cry about on, you know, an occasional basis. So I always try and give something back, you know, military vets, anything like that. And I've gotten so many messages from people that have just been like, hey, I lost 20 pounds. You know, hey, I love your posts every day. And that's the stuff, like, that's pretty cool. That will actually negate all that dumb stuff, you know, when somebody wants to be like, oh my God, you're so hot, but you sound like
a man.
Well,
that's the thing. It's like,
you know, whatever.
You know, you got to take the good with the bad.
Well, from Long Island, you know, we have thick skin, so we really don't care.
Yeah.
Well, we're just going to tear you right back up on the flip side. So it's okay either way.
I love it. I wish you could read out what you wrote to that person. Like, it was like
it was not a good one.
Let's get into, let's move out of the bodybuilding, because then you started to get into physical training. And okay. I think this is going to interest a lot of people because we have a lot of people who probably have a million questions sure. on how to get in shape, how to lose that extra weight and stuff.
A lot of people don't want to join the gym.
I want you to get into that.
Oh, that's a cool zip code or area code.
Hello, strongisland.com. Who's on the line? Where are you calling from?
This is Sandy Grega from Hi, Florida. Sandy.
Oh, Florida.
Hi,
cool.
Sandy from Florida.
Hi.
What's on your mind, Sandy?
HelloStrongIsland.com.
Yeah, don't listen.
Oh, yeah, turn the volume down. We're on a delay.
Yeah, mute the computer and just talk to us on the phone.
Hi, Sandy from Florida.
Oh, I can hear you.
Hi, Tara. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great, honey. I'm so glad to hear you.
Well, thank you. It's been this has been an exciting evening so far.
I'm trying.
So, yeah. Sandy, what do you have to say? What do you want to say to Tara?
I just want to say how proud I am of her. She's very deep in my heart. I've known her since an infant.
Yeah, literally from an infant. Yes, yeah.
Literally from yeah. an infant.
Yeah,
I couldn't be any prouder of anyone than her.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It means so much to me that you even took the time to call.
Yes, thank you so much.
Of course I would.
Yeah, we love her. I mean, like I said, I've known her a few years, and she's just that girl. She's got a big heart.
Yeah, I
try. She certainly does.
If only right. Grandma could see us now, huh?
Oh, you got it. You got it.
All right, so thank you for calling. We appreciate it. If you can share the Facebook Live feed, we'd love you for that. So
will
thank
do.
You again.
Love you, Tara.
Thank you. I love you, too.
Thanks
All
for
right,
calling.
Bye.
Much love.
Bye, hon.
Okay, so back to our conversation. The transition from bodybuilding to personal training, how did you, when did you come to life?
I was always kind of training, you know, other people. So it just kind of fell into place, you know. So even when I was getting ready for my shows, I mean, I was still working. I was working corporate jobs and doing training kind of on the side or at night. And then a few years back, I just walked into my boss's office one day and had, I would say, like, I don't know if it was a midlife crisis, but, you know, I looked around and everybody was miserable.
No, it's
and
an epiphany.
I just
Not a
decided,
midlife crisis, it's an epiphany.
It,
I meant for
yeah,
more than this.
It was kind of weird. You know, you walk into your boss's office and, you know, when you say the words like, hey, I think I'm going to quit now, this is my 2-week notice, you can't stumble backward and be like, I was just kidding.
Yeah, yeah.
Because, you know, it just doesn't work.
Yeah.
So the words had just kind of come out of my mouth, and he looked at me like, you know, what?
Like,
and,
why?
That was it. 2 weeks later, I just never looked back. I went and started in a gym in Texas, and it just kind of, I don't know if you want to call it luck, or it just worked.
No, it was purpose.
It was meant to be.
Happened.
It was what you were meant to do. Yeah, it was purpose.
So it just grew into one thing or another, and then, of course, you know, along the way, you get these other connections and things with people, and things just kind of grow and take off from there.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not competing. You know, I haven't competed in a couple years. Not to say that I won't again. There's a
there will be one competition that rears its little head,
gonna
and you're going to
be
just show me. You know what? I need to do that.
Tiny.
We got to show. You got to show the muscles a little bit for a minute. Yeah, you
point.
Do.
I
but
know.
Like,
I'm so itty bitty, so itty bitty. But,
I know. I
well, and I think when you met me, I was probably at one of my biggest, too.
Yeah, you were pretty diesel. I was like, oh, I don't want to piss her off. We got another caller.
Strong Island Live. Who's on the line? Where are you calling from?
Hi, my name's Miranda. I'm calling from Great Neck.
Okay, Great Neck. What was your name again?
Miranda?
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 Okay. Miranda, I'm sorry.
Hi.
Hi,
is Tara Rickert still there?
Yeah, she's here.
Yeah,
you
she
can
is.
Talk to her right now. Go ahead.
Hello.
Oh my. Hi, Tara.
Hello.
Oh my gosh. Hi, Tara. My name is Miranda, and I have a couple questions because I'm struggling very much. I'm trying to, like, I'm sorry, I'm listening, I'm hearing myself.
Mute
it.
Lower the computer or the phone.
We're on
delay. And just talk to us.
I'm struggling very much because I'm very petite and I'm very small, but I'm, like, working out and I'm lifting, but I'm having a really hard time, like, gaining mass. Like, I just feel like I'm getting skinnier rather than built. Is there
That's actually a really good question. Yeah. I think most women are afraid to lift heavier weights.
Yeah, I don't want to get like super where I'm like you. I don't. Sorry.
Super muscle.
You will never.
Like, I love how you look and what I'm, but you know, I don't want to get like where I'm like super muscular, but I'm like, you're so in shape, and I can't seem to like gain enough weight to look where I'm muscular and
okay, hold on, okay. Miranda, hold on. Listen. She's going to answer you now. Give her a chance. Hold on.
Most women are afraid to lift heavy. The first thing you need to do is not be afraid to lift heavy. You will never, ever, 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 ever get super big unless you decide to take steroids or some other stuff. It is not going to happen. So if you add mass and add muscle.
I see girls like doing squats at the gym and I'm so nervous and I'm like, I don't want to... Like, I love how you look, and I follow you on Facebook, but I'm like, I'm this tiny little thing. I'm like, oh, my gosh, I'm like, I'm afraid I'm going to look, like, heavy when I'm wearing clothes if I'm muscular, but I can't, like, seem to, like, I just get skinny, not, like...
You're probably not eating enough, and again, I don't know your entire background of stuff, but I would say of something like that, one, you're probably not eating enough. And two, you're probably not lifting heavy enough to put that size on.
Okay.
So hopefully,
so like literally, if I like go and do like squats, like boys are doing, I'm not gonna get like.
No, you will. No, you will not get overly.
I feel
big.
So Lady weird, like even like, very too, I'm yes, like yeah, wow, very, I'm on the radio and I'm asking it.
Very different. Two chemical makeup. So
Miranda, we're gonna let her answer that question. We're gonna let you go, but stay on the line, stay on the feed because we're gonna address that right now. Okay. Thank you for calling.
Awesome. Thank you guys.
Thanks,
thank
Miranda. You. Good luck with what you're trying to do, hon.
Yeah. Much love and
that's
contact her.
So let's
because
lot, actually,
she's gonna keep asking you a million questions. Yeah. But all right. So, and this not just goes for women because this is guys too. I actually have this problem too. How does somebody put on mass? I mean, obviously, you have to increase your weights because if you do light weights, more reps, you're going to cut up. You're going to get skinnier.
You don't really cut up, but it's not really going to do you any good either. You know.
All right, hold on just 1 second, okay? We're going to come right back to you. Hold on, please. All right, so give us some advice, men or women, how to bulk up a little more.
You need to have a slight surplus in calories because obviously, you know, like dieting, you obviously deplete, you actually take. You know, take your calories down so you lose weight. It would just be slightly opposite. You'd want to increase your calories slightly, you know, 250 calories a day, give or take. And again, this is very general. I'm not
250
specific.
More than what you're
and
usually
and that's healthy, not like Laffy Taffys and
correct.
Popcorn.
Correct, yes. We're still thinking about good, clean foods, not cheeseburgers, not, you know, things that your body will grow off of. Rice, potatoes, those good carbs, real protein, chicken, fish.
Well, everybody's bodies are different, too.
Exactly.
So maybe if they connect,
yeah, like I said,
they connect with you.
It's still a very general
what about like
answer,
a protein?
Protein shakes are a great way to supplement your... You know, supplement your diet, especially if you can't eat as much of that food. A lot of people can't fit all that food in. It's a lot of food to eat when you're trying to put that mass on. And of course, then you want to lift in that 8 to 10 range. You know, where it's heavy, you should be struggling.
Where you should
by your 10th
just
rep.
Getting out that 10th.
If
rep.
You're getting 12 to 15 reps, then I would usually tell you it's too light.
Okay. All right. Cool. All right. Strong Island Live. Who's on the line? Where are you calling from?
Yes, my name is Angie, and I'm calling from Houston, Texas.
Hi, Angie.
Ooh, Texas, what up?
And I just want to say she is the best trainer ever.
This,
client, a friend?
She was one of my clients, yes,
nice.
Yes. Yes, I know that voice anywhere, kind of like mine. How are you?
I'm good.
Good.
I just called to say, Pete.
Well, Pete, back to you, my dear.
No, I'm watching you live, and I wanted to say hi. You look beautiful.
Thank you.
I miss you,
too.
Can't wait to see you back in Texas.
Any day now.
Don't take her back too fast. Hey,
any
we're not
day now.
No, we're loving her on Long Island. She's got some fans over here.
Oh, I know. Well, she's an awesome trainer. She knows what she's talking about. She's a mom. Love her to pieces.
Aww. Thank you, Angie.
Thank you, Angie. Thanks for calling in, hon. We love that you're watching.
I love you too. Thank you.
Yeah, much love, Angie.
All right, so bye.
Bye, Sarah.
Thank you so much for calling.
Funny.
All right, so we have a
got a lot of love here.
We got a nice little
chat.
Comment on here from Jerry. So many focus on her body and looks, but the true beauty of Tara is her kindness and willingness to help others. A beautiful person inside and out.
Thank you, Jerry.
That is the truth, though.
And Jerry and I have worked together. I know exactly who that is. He is my sponsor with the clothing company. He owns Wicked Iron Clothing. And, you know, when he approached me with that stuff, again, it was, you know, one of those things that, like, mutant, you know, it was just kind of, you know, just fell out of nowhere, you know. And he had just said, you know, he'd been watching my Facebook media and my Instagram media.
Well, see, so it wasn't out of nowhere, my love.
And he says, you know, I've been sitting back and just kind of watching, you know, watching what you do behind the scenes. And it just, we kind of developed a great, you know, business rapport. And I would say even with the people, you know, from Mutant and Wicked Iron, you know, it's at the point where I don't really feel like I work for them. You know, it's
like a partnership.
It's really been something else. And it's very difficult to explain or even put into words that way. But it's such a huge blessing. I mean, and Jerry's a great guy. I mean, there's nothing I don't think he wouldn't do, you know, for me too.
You have a lot of love too. You have an Adam from League City, Texas, V12 Gym. He shouted out.
What's up, Adam?
Michelle, right? We have a Michelle Myers.
Michelle, yeah.
You know, we'll get to more people, but
we got another caller.
Oh, let's take it.
Pretty popular. We don't get this many calls.
Really?
Strong Island Live. Who's on the line? Where are you calling from?
Strong Island. Hi, my name's Karen. I'm calling Tara Richards on your show.
Yes, she is. You can talk to her. Go ahead.
Hello.
Oh, wow. Oh, okay. Wow. What if I can hear myself? That's weird. I was just wondering. I know Tara's originally from Long Island, but now she's in Texas. When she comes up to New York, is she like available for like personal training or?
That's a good question.
Yeah, occasionally I do that when I travel. It's a little difficult to line up depending on my schedule and things that are going on, but there is a spot on my website. If you go to zerotowicked.com, you can always contact me and find out where I'm going to be, what my next location is.
Okay.
And I will actually come out and train different people.
Is it sort of like, do I have to like sign up for a membership you'll meet me at a gym and just...
Yeah, I'll work
casual,
out.
Like,
I will work
I don't
out
really want to like sign up for like sessions and like the whole thing. Like every time I go to a gym, they make it like, sign up for personal gym. It's very awkward. Like, but if you're like, if you come to New York, is there like if I hit you up on your
there's a couple
website,
gyms and stuff that I work with that we can arrange that kind of thing. Sure, just contact me through my website.
And she's going to do that.
ZeroToWicked.com?
ZeroToWicked.com, correct.
Awesome, thank you.
All right, cool.
You're very
Thanks
welcome.
For the call, much love.
Thank you.
Thanks for the call.
Got a lot of great fans, man.
Yeah,
so many people are so excited that you're here.
Yeah, it's...
Did you, like, not tell people that you were coming to Long Island? Is that what happened?
I did. sometimes
like,
I do and sometimes I don't. You know, I came up earlier last week, and it was really just about spending some time with my family.
Right.
You know, my sister's here, and my nephew and brother-in-law, and, you know, things like that. And I really wanted to get down and to see my parents and stuff, and that just kind of didn't really work out this trip. But sometimes I'll kind of broadcast it that I'm going to be in the area, and that's usually if I'm coming up to do work or, you know, doing things that
or like
would
a
be
show
a little
or
involved.
Something.
Mm-hmm. This was a little bit more of a personal trip, and then, of course, you know, I worked out just a few little things to really do while I was here.
Well, we appreciate you working us into your schedule with
this
a personal trip. I mean, for real. Like,
thank you.
This is awesome.
I have a question for you, okay? Because this is my problem, okay? Because I know that you can work out all you want, but diet is the most important. What you eat.
Is it the most important thing?
No,
though? That would be the question.
It absolutely is.
Just as important as working out, if not more. But my question is to you is, you know, I come into work 6, 7 o'clock. I get done like 12 o'clock. At 12:15, I'm coming home. It takes me a while to wind down. I'm starving at that point.
Well,
and I cannot control myself.
Did you eat the first part of that day?
Yeah.
What did you eat the first part of that day?
Fast food.
No, I eat pretty good. I eat pretty good, but my last meal is at 5:30, 6 o'clock. So by the time 12 o'clock, 12:30 rolls around, I'm still wound up. I get home. I can't fall asleep. I don't fall asleep till 12 o'clock. So from 6 o'clock to 2 o'clock in the morning, there's 8 hours that goes
by. Which you should then be eating.
Mm-hmm. And I'm getting hungry at that point.
You should still be eating about that every 3 hour range. I mean, I'm not saying you might not have a full meal at that time. Don't go eating, you know, steak and potatoes right before you go to bed. But a protein shake, yeah.
Here's a question. What are the best things to eat before you go to bed?
Well, like, that's
if you are like, oh my gosh, my stomach is growling. I cannot fall asleep because my stomach isn't full. What are the best things to eat before bed?
I'm not a big snacker. Per se. You know, some people like to call it 3 meals, 3 snacks a day. I like to call it you eat 6 meals a day.
Yeah.
That's just the way I roll. I think snacking lets people think they can have kind of anything.
Yeah. I piss off my boyfriend because I don't eat a full meal. I eat small.
Right. Well,
exactly.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, to me, that's a meal.
I call myself a grazer.
Six small portions,
but that's what you're supposed
adequately
to do.
Portioned
meals
or
big
a day.
Breakfast.
Yeah, but what somebody's used to like.
Big lunch, but dinner.
There's so many studies on things in different ways. The way I prefer to do it, you know, and that's just my way.
But I'm just thinking about what is the most healthy thing to eat before you're going to sleep.
I would usually opt for something not so much like a whey protein shake, but a casein protein shake. It's it's an egg-based protein, so it takes a little longer to digest, so you're not starving. You know, it doesn't digest quickly like a whey protein really kind of goes through.
So it'll keep you full throughout the night so you don't wake up with your stomach growling.
So usually I'll do like a casein protein with a tablespoon of peanut butter. And I can fit a lot of peanut butter on a tablespoon.
I was going to say like that chocolate casein with the peanut butter.
You know you can make a cookie out of
that.
You know you can make a cookie out of casein protein?
No.
I don't even know what casein protein is. I'll eat regular cookie, though.
Chrissy's on a whole list.
No, I've heard of it, but I haven't worked with it.
Take the scoop of casein, a little bit of baking soda.
How do you feel about that PB2?
I don't. It's okay.
I know. I hear mixed reviews. I haven't tried it.
No.
It's okay.
A girl I work with
eats that. The consistency is a little weird.
Yeah, I don't like it.
It is, right?
It's grainy.
It's weird.
It's very grainy. But they have natural peanut butter.
Okay.
Natural peanut butter is pretty good.
That's usually what I do. Natural almond butter.
It's the healthiest version.
But you can throw a tablespoon in there and then just enough water to make a cookie dough.
But it doesn't stay forever, though. Like, natural peanut butter, you got to eat that in a month. Or like 3 weeks or something like that.
Some people can manage to do it in a couple days.
Listen, last year, it's funny. I haven't seen Tara in a long time, but I think maybe last year I saw you, but I lost last year around Christmas. I lost 20 pounds in a couple months, and it was not even working out. It was just eating good
food.
And I remember, like, you had told me, like, you know, meals, like every three hours, eat something. I stopped eating before 8 o'clock at night. I was still drinking. I mean, I would drink vodka club like every night.
But that depends on how late you stay up? Because if you stop eating,
if you stay
at 8,
up late,
and if you're up until 3 a.m., you're going to die.
You're on a night
two or three hours before you plan on going to sleep is the safe.
My schedule runs so tight sometimes. I mean, I'll get up at, you know, 4 in the morning. I'm usually eating my first breakfast while I'm training my first client. And then, you know, I'll go through my meals there. But if I don't, you know, go to bed until 11, 10, 11 o'clock at night, I'm usually eating my last meal like an hour before I go to bed.
Yeah.
Or I'm not going to get my calories and, you know, like I'm not going to get all my food in. Yeah. So, but that's just how my day works.
You know. See, this is info for New Year's resolutions coming up because, you know, everybody's back in the gym January 1st.
Yeah,
and people think that, you know, like
that annoying
a certain
you?
Schedule is...
It used to.
Like, is the gym, when you go to work on January 1st, is it like, oh, my God, all these people will be here?
The gym I work in is kind of, I say, kind of quiet. I mean, it's a pretty private facility for the most part.
Okay. It's not like LA Fitness or
No.
Power.
I mean, we still get, an influx of people and some things like that, but not nearly like you do, you know, at LA and some of the other places. And, I mean, I train at those places, too, but it doesn't really bother me. I mean, I think... It used to, you know, it's just be like, wow, these people are just in my way.
Yeah.
You know, when you have a goal and you're going, you know what you're doing. The last thing you want is people just kind of flustering around, you know, and getting in
and
your way.
And talking and all the BSing.
Now, I mean, I see people now and I mean, I think it should be a little bit more motivating for them. You know, at least they're trying. You know, one out of those 50 people might make it.
Yeah.
You know?
I have a quick question. Recently, I saw a picture of Planet Fitness with a table of pizza.
That's true.
Why?
They are the anti-gym. I don't know.
I was going to say,
fun of this all day.
Why and is...
Planet Fitness, I don't think will be hiring me anytime soon
tanning.
For anything. So.
Yeah, no, but I was just, I mean, like...
they don't want it to be an intimidating atmosphere.
No, yes, okay, but that doesn't mean there needs to be
correct,
pizza.
Which is just flat out.
I've never seen me, pizza. Stupid.
I saw a picture that somebody had literally walked into a Planet Fitness.
Yeah, it's, I think it's every Friday or whatever.
There was a table full of pizzas there, and they took a picture because they were like, "What?" I guess they had just joined and they had never seen it before, and they were like, "What? What's the deal with this? Is this like, you know,
it's
to keep
your
them?
That
is, I was gonna say, is that to keep them in business? No. Is this like a protein
that is, no,
pizza?
No, no, no. That gym
or something,
no, is
the, you first know, off, like that kind of thing.
First
like,
off, Thin Crust Pizza.
And I'm not trying to talk bad about any gym.
No,
or
don't
anything. Jamie, I just didn't understand.
That,
I didn't
that.
Know if there was Jamie. Like a motivation behind it or something.
The motivation is. They want you to keep fucking paying to come there and work out, and they're going
to
keep feeding you pizza so you feel like a fat fuck.
I wasn't trying to call them out like that. I'm not even kidding. I wasn't sure if there was, like, if, like, they had pizza there for
It's like a treat.
No,
it's
I was thinking
that it might be a treat with a different kind of dough and a
No.
Do you know what I mean?
Anthony's pizza on the corner of 110 and freaking
positive. I've never seen pizza at Planet Fitness.
I will find the picture. I'm not saying, but
I've never go there.
No, I
I've
know.
Never I'm, seen it there.
Maybe they don't anymore
and that's
because
why
they
I'm
got
saying,
complaints.
Like
they probably seen pizza.
This was years ago. No, no, no.
Okay.
I went to Planet Fitness a few years ago.
Does anybody know?
I'm not kidding.
Does anybody know?
I saw it like a month ago, a picture.
Yeah,
I'm not doubting
sure
it. I'm just saying. It's not like you walk into every Planet Fitness and there's a pizza there. Or
take any new sign-ups,
not every day.
Well, like, they came up with some, like, sort of after-workout.
No.
Sort of. Is that the blonde in
I
me?
I will tell you. Yes,
that
must
be.
Yes.
That is the blonde in me. Thinking that they came out with,
I wish that was
I used to go to Planet Fitness.
Can you imagine?
And we did it one day a week.
Protein pizza.
It probably wouldn't taste
Pizza's
good.
Pizza's not that bad for you, though.
Strong Island Live. Fit. Who's on the line? Where are you calling from?
Depends on how much
My name is Karen, and I am Tara Rickard's sister.
Hello.
Hi, Karen.
Hi, sweetie.
Is this the sister with the nephew?
Yes.
Y'all are talking about pizza.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I know. I'm getting hungry, and they're trying to tell me how to lose weight, and they're making me hungry.
That's usually my go-to meal, actually.
Yeah, pizza.
Listen, not for nothing. This is the only woman I know who can go, nah, don't get the bacon and meatball. Don't get the pepperoni. Get the plain cheese, and then it comes here, and she don't eat it.
She'll tell you.
I eat like two slices.
She just wants
three,
to smell it.
Three.
She goes, oh, it smells
then,
like pizza. All right, I'm going back to Texas. I'm like,
I have that same issue, though, too, that sometimes I can purchase something and not have to eat it just to get the satisfaction out of it. As sick as that
she
sounds.
She has
like
got the most willpower of anybody I know.
Not always, but like most of the time. It's
okay. Yeah, most of the time.
Food.
I love you.
I'm glad I didn't bring the Christmas cookies I was going to.
Yeah, no, thanks.
All right, kiddo.
Thank you for calling. We appreciate
thanks
it.
Thanks for calling, kid.
Much love, sister.
Love you.
Love you too.
I love you guys. Strong Island.
Yeah, girl.
All right, so listen, I just want to shout out some people first. And Jerry Early says, once per month customer appreciation at Planet Fitness. That's what
that's what it is.
Okay, I've never seen it. I've probably been going maybe 3 months. I've never seen it.
I was
going
to say, next time you need to find out when that customer appreciation is and tell them to get it from mommy.
Let's just shout out Sandy, Michelle Myers, Richard Bosmans, Brad Duncan, Caleb Willie. Becca Wright, Sam Gonzalez, Sam and Lori from League City, Janine Francis, Angie Enderly, Carmen Santarelli, Adam Sens or Sains, Johnny Mnemonic, a lot of people here, so we just want to shout everybody out. Jennifer Nasta.
Yeah, girl. Shout out to Nick Lee from Mutant.
Hey, Nick.
Much love.
Sue Richardson, Benji Ward.
Jay Price, as always.
Michelle Myers,
yes,
Richard Riccoboni.
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 My boy.
I didn't want to say Boney.
From growing up.
One of my first best friends.
He's
Liz,
aware.
My cousin Brittany out in Cali.
Nick Lee. And Laurie McCain Gonzalez.
Oh, Dim tuned in,
we
too.
We appreciate it.
You know, one thing I wanted to bring up, too, because, you know, we touched on the bodybuilding.
Yeah.
We touched on a lot on the training.
Yeah.
Now, I know of you to be a fitness model as well, and you have this sick calendar with your little bitty
parts.
Can we still
purchase this calendar?
Yeah,
I
think it's still on the womenofarmageddon.com.
That's what it's,
I
was trying to remember the
Mike
name.
Mike Zinn and I worked together, he caught me in 2013, I was with the first calendar I did. That's when I met you. Yeah. Way back when, I did that 2013 calendar, and then in 2016 he approached me again and had me come out, and we shot the second, my second calendar. It's been quite a series of stuff, but I love him as a photographer. He's amazing. I mean, he's super innovative, and the look, I mean, it is so badass.
That's why I wanted to bring it up, holding guns and
yeah, cannons.
This chick naked with like guns in her hand and cannons.
Yeah, that was a 50 cal sniper rifle they had me carrying around last time.
Women of Armageddon. I'm like, she's
fun.
Picking me up on the way.
Fun stuff. I was a little scared at that shoot, though. I mean, they had us at that zombie apocalypse place. It was kind of creeping me out.
I haven't been there, but it's pretty creepy. That's cool, though.
It was a little frightening.
All right, yeah. So why don't you shout out some of your sponsors and people you work with?
Yeah, of course. You know, we talked about Mutant, Nick Lee at Mutant. They've been my supplement sponsor for a couple months now. Jerry Early, Wicked Iron Clothing. I'm going to be doing a lot of work this upcoming year. I'm sponsoring some shows with Raw Iron Gym in Mount Pleasant, Texas. There's a couple things going on out there. They're going to do a big, the American Cup, the NASA American Cup powerlifting meet, as well as the Texas Punisher, which will be a pro qualifying event. So we're looking forward to that, and there'll be plenty of information you guys can find at the Raw Iron Gym website. I'm doing some work with Team Arise. They raise money for disabled veterans, for scholarship funds for disabled veterans and their families. So we're going to kind of all coordinate some stuff this upcoming year. So there'll be some big things going on this year. And of course, you know, I just really launched the big part of my online training programs. So hopefully we can reach out and get a few more people, you know, New Year's resolution. Yeah. You know, online training is super affordable in comparison to
absolutely
real life training.
Yeah, and all you need is motivation.
Yeah, it really does
hopefully
make it
simple. Hopefully you'll be able to do a lot more, too, in the future with, like, people being able to tune in all together live.
We were talking about some other things and doing some other stuff. So hopefully we can get all that stuff together this year, too. It'll be an exciting year.
Yeah. Oh, that's awesome. Well, we wish you the best.
Thank you. Yes. I had a great time tonight. Thank you for having me.
Yes. And
thank you for being here.
Shout out your social media information, your website, so people can follow you.
Website's really simple. It's zero to wicked, zero, the number two, wicked.com. You can find me on Facebook, Tara Rickert. There's probably 9 or 10 accounts out there at this point. Yeah. Instagram, of course, also Tara Rickert. Twitter, same. Basically just Google my name.
You'll also be able to find her, like, you know, through us with the strongisland.com and stuff.
Strongisland.com.
We'll make sure to tag her and all that.
Yep. You can always look at some of the other things, Team Arise, Raw Iron Gym, Mutant, any of these, you know, find things, Wicked Iron.
You said your Facebook page, right, Tara Rickert?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, everything's basically under my name. So, awesome. Like I said, if you can't find me, just Google me.
And if you can't find her, look
Google
us up
me.
And we'll tell you where to find her.
Somebody will tell you where to find me.
Yes.
Yes.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, really.
Yes.
This has been awesome.
And,
it's been great.
I thank you, myself. I'm going to step away for a second because Half Chub is not here.
I know. I scared him off. I'm so sorry. I'll never post anything like that again.
all right. So, ladies, why don't you guys close off the show? I'm going to go over there and do some technical stuff.
Closing it
and,
out.
And I'll see everybody next week. God bless.
Awesome.
Well, Jamie,
I know. Don't you feel powerful?
No, I feel kind of put on the spot. What are we going to
I was going to say, I'm like, I feel powerful. Now it's ours.
Oh, bye. Ladies night. That's right. I didn't even finish my wine yet.
Wait.
Cheers.
Oh, wait.
You're done.
I finished a little while ago. But yeah.
We just want to wish everybody
a very
happy
new year.
Yeah, happy new year.
Oh my gosh. And let's all thank 2016 for the lessons.
And the blessings.
And the blessings that we have all received and experienced. Because 2017, man, we're all coming for you.
Yeah, and we won't see you till next year. So we hope, you know, maybe instead of the usual things that people have for their
resolutions,
you know, like
let's
me
make
is
it all positive.
Every year, probably every day, it's losing weight because I'm a fluctuator. Like, one minute I'm in my best shape.
I'm going to be a happier, healthier, and better me.
Yes.
I like that resolution.
Mind, body, and soul. I feel like that's the most important thing. Everybody needs to be a little nicer because there's a lot of trolls out there on now the internet and social media are going on and stuff.
More positivity.
Just be a good person because you know what? We have a lot of a-holes out there and it's not helping.
Be kind.
It's just not helping anybody.
Be kind.
You know, we all go.
Be kind to yourself. Yeah. Be kind to others. Be kind to the world. Be kind to the planet. Just be kind.
We all go through our struggles.
Make that your resolution.
You don't know what kind of issues people are facing, so it's important that you remember.
My
like,
pop-up used to say, it's always nice to be nice.
Exactly.
That will be tattooed on me eventually.
Let's go. I'm ready. I'm going to get mine, too.
Hey, tattoo shop's right up the street.
I know. That's where we go. And they're open late tattoo places. We should go right after this. I haven't been drinking. Just tattoo it right there. I don't feel a thing.
I you know, some of them turn a blind eye as long as they know that you're not going to bleed out.
Yeah. But we just want to thank everybody again. Thanks for watching. Thanks
yes,
for calling
and thank
in.
You so much to Tara. I mean, you know, for her to make the trip and include us.
And
in
we
her
will
personal,
have you again.
And yeah. her oh, personal yeah. visit. I mean, next time you're on Long Island, please let us
Absolutely.
Know because
It'll
we will
be on the itinerary.
We will,
yeah, maybe we can yes, have you do like a little session right
oh my
there
God,
for
I'm gonna
the
wear
green
the 80s
screen.
Clothes. I'm going to wear the Richard Simmons clothes.
Oh my gosh, I will find my
Let's do. Oh my God, we'll go behind you and do the 80s like.
Let's do it.
I'll curl my hair like Shirley Temple.
It's a plan.
Totally do this.
Those little Jerry curls, you know, like but like for white girls, and then do the tight curls.
Leg warmers.
And I want my lips. I'm going to be. I have to get in really great shape for that because I'm at my lip show.
That's why you do the spandex under the leotard.
We're getting to the end of the wine, so you know what that means.
This is the longest closing.
Okay. We're closing.
Witnessed.
We're done. We will see you next year. We love you, Strong
yes,
Islanders.
We love you.
Stay tuned because Tara will be back,
yes.
and it will be entertaining.
And so will we, as long as you'll have us.
Yes. We love you very
Thank
much.
You guys.
Sweet dreams, happy hump day, and happy new year.
Love you.
Power up.